Hi, how are you tonight? I have messed with this so much. My little tripod in my office is not great. And I'm like, you know, you get live and I'm like, oh, I still don't love that angle. Let's see if I can fix it a little bit. That's okay. Like, it just fell off the table a minute ago. So I'm like, okay, we're just gonna let that be what it is. Oh my goodness, how is everybody tonight? I am in between people, in between clients this evening, and I realized it's been a little while since I've been in here, and I have had like nonstop classes. I think maybe the last time I was in here was, God, was I still doing SOP? Like, it's so, that seems like eons ago. And I realized, I think today might be the first day in like a week and a half or something where I haven't had like massive amounts of classes. Like, I didn't actually have any classes today, I just had meetings. So I have been doing so many classes lately, it's just been a little crazy, which is amazing. And I just didn't have words. There was like, I thought about coming live a couple times and there just wasn't, I was so much space, which was amazing, but there just wasn't really words. But I had a client earlier in the week, I don't remember if that was yesterday or the day before. Maybe it was the day before. My days jumbled together. It never used to be like that though. It was like since COVID happened, everything just like time changed. It's really interesting. But anyways, but I had this client the other evening and she's actually coming to me for hypnosis, but the first session, I kind of wanted to like play with access stuff with her a little bit. And I didn't necessarily talk about it in those terms. But we came to some really interesting things and some cool things for her. And it just made me very aware of like how so many people are functioning and where we keep ourselves like small and sort of stuck because we can't see anything outside of where we're at. So like when we're, well, let me tell you the story, I suppose. Maybe that makes more sense. But so she was talking about her relationship and how like they just didn't really enjoy things together. And, you know, he was kind of content to watch TV and to kind of do nothing. And she, you know, had a good job, made good money, but kind of felt like she like couldn't really do anything or like spend any money on anything because like had to check in with the relationship. And like without going into all the details, it was very clear that like she was keeping herself as small as possible to sort of fit in with this reality that they had created. And it was amazing because we kind of went through all these different things. Hi Rogerio, and hi John, I see you're watching too. And we got to this place where I finally stopped and I said, you know, what would you really like to have from your life? And she like teared up and was like, I haven't looked at that in so many years that I don't know. And we sat with it for a little while and we kind of came up with like, she was like, wow, like I love to travel and I love to like go see friends and have drinks on the beach and dance to, you know, random music playing and to play. And she was a little older and she was like, you know, maybe go to like a concert that like isn't a like classical concert, like maybe go to a rock concert. It was really funny. And she got so excited at the possibilities of like when I opened that up to her world of like, hey, what would you actually like for your life? And she's like, wow, I haven't ever looked at any of this. We're talking about her car and she drove kind of like a, you know, lower end model car and she could afford something much greater than that. And, you know, I said, what's stopping you? And I've always been made wrong to like desire anything more than what I have. Like I'm ungrateful or I'm not, like it's not enough for me. And so I said, what if none of that is wrong? And what if it's not wrong to actually desire more for your life, more vibrant life, living joy? And she like, oh my gosh, she was like, I don't think anybody has ever said that to me in my whole life. It's like, oh my gosh. But, and it's so light to hear that it's not wrong to actually desire more. And I was like, and the session went on, but that little snippet in time, I wish I had it recorded. Like, it was such a valuable like moment for her and for me to see all the ways that we've like decided that we can't have more, that asking for more is wrong, that anywhere you're saying that my life is fine, but I'd like so much greater. Hi, Tina. Is not an okay thing. That like, oh, somehow I'm ungrateful if I'm saying that I'd like to do bigger things, to be more, to experience more, to laugh more, to dance more, to live life. And what if none of that is actually wrong? What if it's the most beautiful thing if we're willing to actually ask for what we truly desire? So, I started looking at this a lot. Like, what is it that you truly desire? You know, and we talk in Access Consciousness a lot about like our asks, or what are your asks, or actualizing our asks, basically. And, and sometimes I get stuck doing that because I'll make a list and I'll come through them all. But then it's like, you have to ask for each one. Like, who does this belong to? Is that actually what I desire? Or is that what I think I'm supposed to desire? Is that what everybody around me desires? Or is that what everybody around me thinks that they're supposed to desire? You see the trap in this, right? And so just to really look at, like, when you look at your life and like what you'd really like to have, what are those things? And some of them are things, and some of them are energies, and some of them are things that you might just not have words for. But what if none of it is actually wrong, and you can have all of it if you choose it? It's funny. I was on a team meeting today. I had my first like team meeting. I've been kind of pulling people into my business, which has been so much fun, and asking for more. So that's a whole side note. But but we were talking a little bit about this topic. I have a one-off call coming up. I think I decided it's gonna be April 10th. I don't have anything up on that yet. This topic came up today. So when I do, it'll be in here. But we're gonna call it More Please. Having your cake and eating it too. That is the call. I'm really excited about it, actually. But that concept of, now I got totally sidetracked. But that amazing like concept of like, what can you ask for? And what if you decided you like is too big for you to ask for? So one of my friends on my team was saying, that he used to look at like pictures online or whatever of these like beautiful like mansions with infinity pools overlooking the ocean and all of those things. And there was a time in his life where he was like, I'll never even go to a place like that, let alone own a place like that. And now, like, that he's been using the tools of Access, has been like, oh, that is completely possible and totally within my reach. And just starting to look at like what else really truly is possible, and all the ways that we've decided at some age, be it when you were a little kid and your parents said, oh, well, like, we know, you know, our family doesn't have that kind of money, or, you know, whatever it was that like was told to you, or where you got the impression that like certain things were out of your reach, that like it was only for the rich or only for a certain class of people, and that like you would never be that. Like, anywhere in your life that you've done that or cut yourself off and decided that like I can only have this much money, and I can only have this amount of wealth, and I can only have this kind of a job, or I can only make money from working for somebody else. I mean, all the ways that we've really sort of cut ourselves off from what is possible. And when you start asking for things that are big enough, that are really the things that like you really truly desire, that you didn't even think were possible, and start asking for those, and you're gonna be amazed how things like actually show up. It's amazing. So I've been doing the Advanced How to Become Money workbook with Glenys Hughes. And something, what's fun about the How to Become Money workbook and the Advanced How to Become Money workbook, that's a lot to spit out, is you write down like some of your asks like throughout things. And so you go back, and I always do them in pencil. And then I go back and look at my, like, I erase my last answers and do the next one the next time I go through it. And it's been amazing to look back and see that the last time I did it was, I don't know, 6 months or a year ago or something. And which I don't recommend. You should, you know, I'm not going to tell you should, but it's beneficial to do more than that. But to go back through and to see that like all the things that I was asking for even 6 months ago are either have been actualized, are on their way to be actualized, or have shown up in completely different ways than I ever would have imagined they would have, but have still shown up. And so when you actually ask for things, the universe, we have this ask and receive thing where the universe actually like reformats the quantum entanglements and the molecules for the things that you're asking for to show up. But you do have to give it a second. Not always, sometimes it shows up tomorrow, but thank you, John. And sometimes it shows up the next day, but sometimes it doesn't show up for 6 months or a year or however long. Sometimes it might be 5 years. But would you be willing to ask for what you truly desire even if it didn't show up in this lifetime, but it still showed up for you, maybe in your next life or the one after that? Or it might show up tomorrow or next week. When you think about all the things that you've asked for in your life and how much they have shown up in ways that you would have never imagined, we start to get a sense of how magical we actually are and how easy it can be to actualize what we truly desire. So my thought in all of this, and something I started to do, and then I was like, no, I'm gonna do a live on this. And so I'm like, what time is it? I have another client, 8 minutes. So we'll see if I have time to do this now, but at some point. I'm gonna make a new list of asks, and I do this probably every month or so. And it's so, and save it, truly. Make a list of asks, but don't limit yourself to like what you think can show up or what you think is possible. And if you could ask for absolutely anything, if, you know, think like genie, except the genie is you, but like, you know, shows up and is like, hey, you can have absolutely anything out of life. What would you ask for then? So not what you think is possible, not what your parents told you is possible, not what your friends have or your friends think is possible. But if you were willing to stretch completely beyond that and start asking for what you would truly, truly desire, yeah, see what shows up. And just, you know, write them down, voice record them, do whatever you want to do, but see what can actualize without you even having to do anything to try to figure it out or to try to figure out the how. And that's one of the biggest things that I've talked to people about lately, because they're like, well, these are all my asks, but I don't know how to actualize that. I don't know how to make it show up. You don't have to figure out how. You just have to ask. Now, obviously, if it shows up, you don't say, no, I'm waiting for the universe to drop it in my lap. When it shows up, acknowledge it and have gratitude for it. But at the same time, like, get that, like, you don't actually have to figure out how it's all going to happen or how it's all going to show up. Trust that it will. And ask the universe and make a demand of yourself that you will follow the energy and do whatever it takes for these things to show up in your life. But that's not from a space of how. It's from a space of just trusting you. So, yeah, like I said, I have a client in a minute. I think I'm gonna go. But anyways, I just wanted to pop in here and talk a little bit about all of that. I'm so grateful for all of you. Please invite your friends to this group. I really enjoy doing lives here. I do them on other pages too, but there's something about the energy of this group that's so much fun for me. So I'm just so grateful. And side note, I have free, if you're local to me, I have free bars day on Friday. I think I have 2 slots left. Free 30-minute bar sessions, and I have a bars class on Sunday. So little shameless plug there. So I hope you guys have an amazing evening, and I will talk to you all soon.